Hello, very good morning to all my dear students. I myself, Mrs. Vishakha Doshi, your English teacher, want to congratulate all for coming in Standard 8. I hope in this session, in this pandemic situation, you and your family members are safe and healthy at home. Now today, in this session, I would like to teach you grammar topic, that is Chapter 1, Phrases and Clauses. Let me first explain what do you mean by a phrase. Define phrase. A phrase is a group of words that can act as an adjective, adverb or noun in a sentence. It does not contain a finite verb but may contain a non-finite verb, a participle or a gerund. It does not make complete sense but can have a meaning through its relation to some part of the sentence in which it stands. For example, leaving behind the dog. Now, this define you all will write in your notebook two times. Now, let me tell you, how many types of phrases are there? Kinds of phrases. Noun phrase, adjective phrase, adverb phrase, verb phrase and prepositional phrase. There are five types of phrases. Now we go to the first number, that is noun phrase. Define a noun phrase. All these definitions you will write in your notebook one time with the given examples. Number one, noun phrase. A group of words that does the function of a noun in a sentence is called a noun phrase. For example, his sudden disappearance is a mystery. His sudden disappearance, this is the noun phrase in the sentence. Now we go to the next, number two, that is adjective phrase. A group of words that does the function of an adjective in a sentence is called the adjective phrase. For example, my neighbor is a man of bad temper. Adding something to the noun, that is adjective, a man of a bad temper, that is adjective phrase. Now we go to the next, number three, that is adverb phrase. A group of words that does the function of an adverb in a sentence is called an adverb phrase. Adding something to the verb, that is adverb. For example, he behaved in a foolish manner. Which type of manner? In a foolish manner, that is adverb phrase in this sentence. Next, number four, that is verb phrase. A verb phrase contains one of the three non-finites, participle, gerund or infinitive, and its objects or modifiers. For example, number one, that is the example of infinitive. You must work hard to get good marks in the exam. To get good marks is the infinitive part in this verb phrase. Number two, he enjoys watching movies at weekends. This is the example of gerund. Gerund means putting ing after the verb. Watching movies is the verb phrase in the form of gerund. Number three, having done the work, he decided to rest. That is example of participle, having done the work. This is the example of participle verb phrase. Now next we go to number five, that is prepositional phrase. A prepositional phrase contains a preposition, its objectives and modifiers of the object, if any. For example, the book is on the table. On the table is the prepositional phrase.